God placed on the Archbishops of Canterbury and York's heart the importance of evangelism and witness. And of course, this must start in prayer. So in 2016, the Archbishops of Canterbury and York put out a call to prayer. The message was to the Anglican Church worldwide to pray for people to come to faith in Jesus Christ. They decided this should happen between Ascension to Pentecost, drawing on the traditional times of prayer as the disciples did in Acts 1 and 2. You will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. Then they returned to Jerusalem and were constantly devoting themselves to prayer. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit, and that day about 3,000 persons were added. Before long, Roman Catholics, Methodists, Baptists, and many other denominations across the world began to join in Thy Kingdom Come, rediscovering the richness of this historic tradition. Momentum quickly built up, with Christians in different countries around the world beginning to pray together during these 11 days for 5 people they knew to become Christians. Year on year, more Christians joined the global wave of prayer, gathering to pray in small groups, churches, families, and as individuals. Prayer took place everywhere, in the streets and in church buildings, in schools and in community spaces, in homes and on public transport, all over the place. Sometimes they prayed continuously for the 11 days, and other times they prayed in the mornings and evenings, or as a family together, or an individual saying a 5-minute prayer on the go. People gathered to pray and celebrate, irrespective of their ecumenical differences. Roman Catholics and Methodists, Pentecostals and Anglicans, Baptists and Orthodox, side by side praying for the presence of the Holy Spirit to work in them for others. Now Christians in more than 100 countries are uniting in this prayer. Come Holy Spirit, let your kingdom come during this time. Will you join us?
We've got the whole of Trafalgar Square on the 9th of June, Sunday the 9th of June, Pentecost Sunday, in the afternoon. And this place will be full of people, and we've got all kinds of wonderful people involved. And it'll be a celebration.
I'll always sing this gospel song. No higher hope, no greater love. A king who came, a life laid down for the world.
What we find with the early church is that they still have a hope, but the hope is really suffused now with joy because something has happened, as a result of which the whole world is a different place and they're part of it.
A king who came, a life laid down for the world. A rugged cross.
That actually there's no better decision anyone can ever make than to be a disciple of Jesus.
A disciple of Jesus. And to discover this strange energy which we call the Holy Spirit.
So come and join us on the 9th of June, Sunday the 9th of June, in the afternoon, to share in thanking God for the water of life and committing to be those through whom that water flows into a thirsty world.
What we're praying for is that Jesus' kingdom will come.
It's a powerhouse of mission because it's a powerhouse of hope.
When the church starts to come together like this, you sense that God is about to do something really awesome.
God invites us to participate in the transformation of the world around us.
There have been Christians gathering in over 85 countries to pray that more people would come to know Jesus.
Wake our hearts and let your kingdom come.
Without prayer, we're useless. There's no such thing as Christian ministry, which is not deeply rooted in prayer.
We are watching, we are waiting, we are hoping, we are praying.
God wants us for this task, establishing God's kingdom, not tomorrow, but now.
Father in heaven, your name is
you're actually journeying into a stream of prayer by the Holy Spirit and Jesus. It's almost like throwing yourself into a river that's flowing very fast.
I believe when I pray, God answers. And we see God's kingdom break out in real and tangible ways.
Every time we say, "Thy kingdom come," we are setting something in motion.
I have found purpose and peace and joy like nothing else has ever given me.
It's like heaven opens up and you get close to God.
Father in heaven, your name is holy. Yours is the kingdom, the power and the glory. God of salvation,
do something, and I feel God say, "I made you." You know, you ask God to move a mountain, God hands us a shovel.
If we pray, we live out our prayers with our actions.
The most amazing thing happened a little while ago. I had the huge privilege of meeting Pope Francis, who is extraordinary. I very cheekily said to him, "Would he give a message for Thy Kingdom Come?" And without a pause, he gave the message you're about to hear. Listen carefully, it is utterly inspiring.
Ven Espíritu Santo. Es como el clamor de todos los cristianos en este día de Pentecostés. Ven Espíritu Santo. La promesa del Padre, la promesa de Jesús, el Espíritu Santo que hará un poco más amplio, más grande nuestro corazón. Nosotros tenemos siempre un problema. El problema es que el corazón se achica, se achica, se achica, se cierra y no podemos solucionar ese problema nosotros solos. Solo lo puede hacer el Espíritu Santo. Ven Espíritu Santo, y a Jesús que venga tu reino, el reino del Padre que tú nos viniste a anunciar. Y hoy ustedes, hermanos míos, con mi hermano Justin Bieber, queremos decirles que los acompañamos en este pedido, que venga tu reino.